Hello everyone and welcome to this video. Now today I'm going to be doing a top 10 list. I'm going to be looking at 10 of my favourite debut singles. So yeah, basically like the criteria for this was quite broad, just like looking at first songs released, like first singles released like by like various like different bands and artists. The only criteria is that I have to like the songs, and like I have to think that they are like good songs. It doesn't really matter if they were hits or not. Like 10 debut singles. How I worked out like if their debut single was from Wikipedia or Discogs, and that was also quite useful. And I guess the only other kind of limiting facts like in this video is like I'm not going to be including like sort of spin-off bands, to say things like Style Council or The Beautiful South. As great as their debut singles were, those artists like in those bands, I could already kind of like were already like well established. So kind of things like that, like I would be like excluding and focusing primarily on like yeah, like just on kind of like the debut like of like each like artist. And this can be quite a like a funny thing really, because some artists like who are some of the most iconic and most well revered artists sometimes start off their career like with a slightly duff single sometimes. I'm thinking of like The Police and Stone Roses and even The Beatles, like to some extent, like Love Me Do is not one of The Beatles' finest moments for me. And like I think like if they'd maybe kicked off say with Please Please Me or like another song, they might have had like a better debut single. So like there are examples like that. I'm like the Kinks is like another one like what comes to mind like as well. Like if their debut single was You Really Got Me, that would have been easily like number one, like number two, like on like this list. But no, so it is like quite I guess and random like to some extent, like sort of like which artist like had like a great debut, and like because there's some here like where I consider like the debut the best song like off like the artist, and like others where I think it was just the start like off a like brilliant career. So I will get started with the list with my number 10 pick. Me, I'm yours, because dreams are me. Which is the song Take Me, I'm Yours by Squeeze. Now I've just got the album here. Most of these I haven't actually got the physical copy like off the single, so I will just show the album that it's taken off. So yeah, this is Squeeze's debut single, and this is a brilliant song, but I think it's quite... It is certainly for me, yeah, like one of Squeeze's best tracks, and one of the ones I listen to that like, I enjoy the most. But it's, I guess, in some ways, it is kind of, it's not representative really of what they would do. It's almost like an electro pop song. This, you've got the kind of this kind of sequencer and kind of things going on, and then kind of like by the time you get to like, the next album, you've got like things like Up the Junction and like a bit more guitar based kind of songs. Yeah, I guess you've still got like Jules Holland's keyboards there, but maybe not quite as prominent like as it is like on this song. But though you have got, like again, like the kind of different into a group sort of trademark vocal on it, with one singing, like an octave higher than the other. And yeah, I think it's a great track and easily the standout moment from this album, which is otherwise quite patchy, I have to say. But no, a great debut there from Squeeze, Take Me, I'm Yours. So in terms of chart position, it reached number 19 in 1978. Same kind of era I was sticking with is Elvis Costello, and his debut single was Less Than Zero, which is taken from the My Aim Is True album here. Now this is a fantastic track. It is possibly my favourite song off this album. I think it really showcases Costello's sharp lyrics with the narrative like of the song about British fascist Oswald Mosley, and the track is very impactful. You've got this kind of very tense kind of guitar riff going on, and then very kind of abrasive guitars on it. Really, I guess, in a lot of ways, established kind of Costello's kind of persona, like what like he would like sort of have like in the early part, like off like his career. Now, unfortunately, this wasn't a hit single by any means. It got roundly ignored upon its release in 1977, and it wouldn't be until his third single, Watching the Detectives, that he would be rewarded with a hit. But no, this is a great album, like all the way through. I just listened to it like earlier, and one of my favourite Costello albums, and that is a great debut single then to kick off his fantastic career there. So that's Less Than Zero. When she smiles my way, my eyes go out. Next up now, I have got the single for this one. This is Perfect Skin by Loicol and The Commotions. Now, they, I guess, really just appeared out of nowhere, like with this single in 1984. It's a classic track. It's got all of the ingredient parts of what make Loicol and The Commotions great, from his kind of like literate lyrics to the kind of Commotions kind of pop jangle. It really is a great song, this. And yeah, like originally I've read that they were going to release another single, I think a song called Down, like Down at the Mission, which is actually like a different song from Down on Mission Street, which appeared on the Rattlesnakes album. So that would have been their single, and it's not a great song. Like I think they had pressed some test copies, but decided against releasing it. And I think that was quite a wise decision, because this was a much better single, I think, to kick off their career. It done pretty well chart-wise, actually. It was one of the Loicol and The Commotions' biggest chart hits, reached number 26 in 1984 there. So yeah, that's her Perfect Skin coming in at number 8.
Way on down south, way on down south, London town.
Next one now I'm going for is Dire Straits' Sultans of Swing. Now, I would say now I'm not the biggest fan like of Dire Straits. I've maybe gone off them like a little bit, but there is no denying that this song, Sultans of Swing, is possibly their crown and glory and most significant song. Like, certainly for me, I think this song stands up really well. Knopfler's guitar on it is very precise, showcasing his unique style, and the lyrics on the song I think are really good. I think it's about it, well it is about a band kind of off musicians kind of playing like in that, like, this sort of drabby venue, and that kind of just sort of describing that like in like great detail. And yeah, this was a great single to kick off their career, one of the most successful Dire Straits singles, reached number 8 in the UK and number 4 in America. And yeah, still for me is my go-to number 1 Dire Straits song, so I had to find a place on this list somewhere, and it would, and like, yeah, like it's at number 7.
Hey, I'm sorry if I go too fast.
Next one's a little bit more obscure, but I'm going for Lions in My Own Garden by Prefab Sprout. Now, this one is more of a kind of personal favourite of mine kind of thing, because it's not one of Prefab Sprout's most acclaimed songs. It certainly wasn't a hit like when it was like released, like either. And like, yeah, like it's not like the signature song like either, like by any means, but just on the list because it is one of my favourite Prefab Sprout songs. I think it's got a certain rawness that they kind of went off like a little bit, like right by the time they got to like the debut album, which is much more jazzier, a lot more well produced and well honed. Whereas this, you kind of got like a kind of like harmonica on it, you've got a kind of a slightly more kind of rough and ready production, like I feel. Still like a great debut single though. And like, I mean, like I love like the later work like as well, like don't get me wrong, but this always for me has been one of my favourite Prefab Sprout songs. So Lions in My Own Garden would come in at number 6.
Is she really going out with him?
Next one up is Joe Jackson's Is She Really Going Out With Him, taken from the Look Sharp album, which I've just recently reviewed a couple of, like maybe getting off about like a month ago now. But yeah, a brilliant classic song, this, from the new wave era. I think, yeah, lyrics are great. I think it can be taken on a number of levels. I think on the one hand, it's full of jealousy and spite, but on the other, it's just really funny, like, I think. A bit tongue-in-cheek kind of style. Now, this again had a bit of a difficult release history. Initially, it failed to chart upon its original release, and it would then reach number 13, I think they reissued it after, like, this album had come out, and, like, yeah, like I said, that was a hit, reaching number 13 in the UK. So, really great song, and I think, yeah, for me, always will be one of my favourite Joe Jackson songs, and it comes in at number 5.
And I'll set her up the West Coast, through villages and towns.
Next one up now is by Deacon Blue, and it's the song Dignity. Now, this is a bit like the Dire Straits one, like in the sense that I don't know, I guess, too much about the rest of their discography. And again, this debut single, like, is regarded as one of their classics. But I guess a bit unlike the Dire Straits one, this one wasn't a massive hit single like upon its original release. When it came out prior to this album, it failed to chart. chart was like completely like ignored, but then was reissued after the album come out and like after a few singles, and it reached number 31. And then again, it was reissued in 1994 to promote a greatest hits album, reaching a new high of number 20. So very much is one of their most well-loved songs. I believe it's a track like they finish like the concerts with like most often, and like, yeah, like is a really well-loved song, especially here in the native Scotland, where it was voted the best track of the 1980s in a 2011 poll run by like STV, like National Broadcaster, like up here. So a great track, and I think, yeah, one of you can blues. Yeah, like easily for me, like their best song, and I think, like, yeah, like a great way to kick off their career there.
Restless dreams, I walked alone.
Okay, next one up is Simon and Garfunkel's song, The Sound of Silence. Now, this is probably the song in this list with the most complex and slightly difficult release history. So yeah, like they originally done it in 1964 on this album, Wednesday Morning 3 AM. This was the first Simon and Garfunkel album. And this was roundly ignored by pretty much everyone. I don't think they even issued any, like they didn't issue like any singles from this at all. The album just came out, no one bought it, and Simon and Garfunkel basically broke up. Now Paul Simon then moved to England, where he recorded this album, the Paul Simon Songbook, as a solo album. And again, this sold poorly, but it does include another version of The Sound of Silence. So when Paul Simon was living like in England, like radio stations like in like America were getting like a lot of like requests like for like this song, like the original version of it here, like on Wednesday Morning 3 AM. And so like, yeah, like it was kind of sort of taking off like a little bit. So the record company, seizing an opportunity here, remixed the track. So they got in a group of session musicians to provide like a Alec to like provide like a like electric backing. So you got like organs, guitars on there, drums. I guess done in the very kind of folk rock vein, like which was like in vogue like at like the time. Like this was all completely against like Simon and Garfunkel's like wishes. Like they didn't have like any knowledge that like the record company like was issuing this like as a single. And then it got to number one like in like America. So a huge hit, and like, yeah, like a great way to kick off like the Simon and Garfunkel career. Like they like after like this reached number one, like they reunited and like I said, like had a stellar career like throughout the rest of the 60s. But surprisingly, this song was never a chart hit like in like the UK. I'm not sure like if it either wasn't issued here or if no one bought it, but like honestly, like I was very surprised to learn that this wasn't a single like at all, like or never like even charted here like in like the UK. So quite surprising that, but a great song though to kick off like the album, just one of the all-time classic tracks there. Okay, and then at number two, we've got the debut single by Oasis, which was Supersonic. So this one, I guess maybe, I guess coming from Sounds of Silence to this, perhaps this one isn't quite as exquisite lyrically like as like that one, but I am ranking this higher. I think just as it is, I guess, the perfect encapsulation like of like Oasis. You know, like they couldn't have sort of started their career like with like a better song. I think it really sets out their stall. You've got great lyrics on it about aspiring to be a kind of, yeah, like a better version like of like yourself. So he sings it like, I'm feeling supersonic, give me gin and tonic, you could have it all, but how much do you want it? And yeah, it's just got that ingredient. You've got the kind of like classic Oasis sound just kind of fully formed like on like this song here. And I guess it sounded nothing like nothing else around like at like the time. It was just a blast of noise, just a wall of noise, this. But I think a really, really great song, and like for me always has been one of my favourite Oasis tracks. As far as its commercial performance, it did all right. It reached number 31 like on the charts, which is not bad for a debut single, but very quickly they would very much take over, well, I was going to say the world, but certainly like Britain like by storm, and like would have a run of like number one singles. But this was very much just the start of it, and I think was a great starting point for them. So that's Supersonic at number two. It's a waste of time if you know what they mean. Okay, Okay, now at number one, I guess you could say I'm being a bit biased here, because he is one of my favourite all-time artists. But I do genuinely think this is one of the all-time great debut singles. So it is Flag Day here by the House Martins. Now, for me, I think this song has all of the classic elements which will go on to define Heaton's career. You've got a political message on it, so this is about the kind of hypocrisy of people, like sort of all like wealthy people giving to charity, like just trying to look good, that sort of thing, like without doing anything to kind of solve like the root cause, like off like the issues. You've then got some beautifully poetic lyrics on it. The first line: too many Florence Nightingales, not enough Robin Hoods, too many halos, not enough heroes, coming up with the goods. A great line to kick off like his career there. And then you've got his voice, like his vocal performance on this is just absolutely stunning. So for me, one of the House Martins' greatest songs here. As it was, this would fail to chart in the UK, like a real shame there, because I think this is one of Hasmo's greatest songs, but they would get commercial success very quickly. I think two singles after this, they'd be releasing Happy Hour, and I guess the rest, is history. A fantastic single, and for me, my personal favourite debut single. So thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you have enjoyed. I would be interested to know what some of your favourite debut singles are, if you think I've missed any notable ones off this list. But yes, I hope you have enjoyed, and I will see you all next time for the next video. Goodbye.